Hi, this is Reporter's Take. I'm Sakshi Batra, and with me is my colleague Vandana Ramnani, and we are here to discuss about the current real estate market scenario amidst the 2019 Lok Sabha elections and how different is the scenario from back in 2014 in the last general elections. Thanks a lot, Vandana, for joining in. Now, a lot has happened in the real estate sector over these past 5 years. There have been many important decisions, policy decisions by the government, plus there have been many disruptive changes also for the real estate sector. Now we talk about RERA, we talk about demonetization, important bills being implemented. How do you really see what's the kind of difference between 2014 general elections, the scenario that was there, and the scenario that is currently prevailing for the sector?
So Sakshi, this is very interesting, because if you go back to 2014, we should remind our viewers that back then, you know, there was a lot of political uncertainty, prices, real estate prices had touched the roof. And, you know, RERA and GST were still to see the light of day.
Yeah.
So, if you come back to 2019, you see that all these reforms have been brought about. GST has been introduced. RERA has been introduced.
Yes.
So, scenario is very different. And also, we must remind our viewers that prices, real estate prices have corrected by almost 30%. So, the scenario... way back in 2014 versus the scenario in 2019 are very different. Very different.
So absolutely, as you say, that there are more and more choices available for the home buyers today. There are prices have rationalized, interest rates have lowered down. But do you see a sentiment improving between the buyers, and do you actually see them going ahead and signing on the dotted line?
See, in 2014, we had found that a lot of buyers were holding back the decision to buy into a house because they were not sure which government's going to come to power, right? And but this time what we are finding is that because there being a lot of ready to move in stock available in the market, they are actually scouting for homes, and if they find the right fit and a house which is within their budget, you know, they are going ahead and signing on the dotted line. And we've also seen developers being more ready to kind of appease the buyers and arrive at a price that suits both of them.
All right, so hard negotiation is taking place on the buying of the flats or houses which are all the home buyers are
so
buying.
So Sakshi, here I must also add that buyers are buying to live rather than to invest. That's one major change that we are seeing this season.
All right, so that's a major change that we are seeing, that people are scouting for houses where they want to live in rather than as an investment property or not. But going forward, if you take a step back, if you could just tell me what have been the trends about inventory and absorption in the last 5 years that you've seen.
So Sakshi, a lot of property consultants say that between 2009 to 2014, just about, we've seen about 10 lakh units that were absorbed. And between 2014 to 2019, around 12 lakh units have been absorbed, which is, you know, an improvement of barely 20%.
Okay.
And right now we're sitting on an unsold inventory of 9.45 lakh units. But if you understand it from the point of view of the goal for housing for all by 2022, at least 1.2 crore houses are required.
All right.
Yeah. So 9.45 lakh is actually a fraction of what the goal is, to arrive at construct 1.2 crore houses.
Absolutely. So there is a huge, construction which is definitely impending and everybody is awaiting that. But what are the expectations of buyers and developers going forward now? We are headed towards May 23rd, when we will be seeing the verdict for the new government also come about. But what are their expectations from the new government and the scenario going forward as well?
So I have spoken to a few home buyers, and what they say is that, RERA should have more teeth, especially where implementation is concerned. They're worried that, more dilutions could take place, and that's something that they do not want. Where builders are concerned, they want more accountability when it comes to, different authorities, because it is delay on the authorities' part that is you know, actually leading to houses not being delivered on time because permissions don't come on time. So these are the issues that need to be ironed out and looked at. So basically these reforms need to be strengthened going forward.
Right. Thanks a lot, Dinmandana, for sharing all these insights. Well, definitely builders and buyers both are hopeful of the scenario improving from here, whether it is via policies, new reforms that come in, or the existing ones also getting more strengthened from here on. Thanks a lot for joining us in this edition of Reporters Take, and do stay logged on to moneycontrol.com for more news and updates. Thanks for watching.